Okay, here we are today with a different project. I'm going to look at this Historex collection. This is obviously, judging by the price, £2.75. This is not a new kit. Three pieces it says from this is Historex. I've got some Imperial Guard Grenadiers, three pieces. The officer, the sapper, engineer, and the grenadier. It's a front view, back view of the grenadier, sapper, officer. La Grande Armée. It's Napoleon's army. Scale 130 or 54mm. From 1804, these figures. So it says on this side it's more in English. Officer, Grenadier and Sapper. Make sure that's in the focus. Officer, Grenadier and Sapper, 1st Regiment Foot Grenadiers of the Imperial Guard. Full dress, 1804. So the sort of thing that turn out to for a parade. Now, I bought this off eBay, it's not complete. It's only got to one complete figure in it. Let's take all the bits out. I bought this about 10 years ago, 15 years ago. Don't actually know. What's this? There's a sort of a advertisement. And I think this is, if there's any bits missing, you can send that back. Same again. And here we have a description of the engineers of the Imperial Guard. If you can get that in there. It's all there. You can always pause and read all that. It's on both sides. Officers all mounted, uniform, horse furniture, etc. Okay, so that's that. Here we have the engineers of the guard. This is, I don't think this refers to this particular kit, because this is not what's in here. Many of the details might be the same. Anyway, that was in the box when it arrived 10 or 15 years ago, whenever I bought this. And these are the assembly instructions. You can see the sapper has this sort of a apron to protect him from whatever it is he's working on. But it's pretty rudimentary. His bearskin together, that's his head with the beard, belt buckle. Okay, turn back. You've got to make these straps yourself. Anyway, we'll come along to that in a minute. And what else? Let's look at the more paper bits. Beautiful card from Historex. Engineers of the Imperial Guard, 1810 to 1815. Sapper. Okay. And there's one sapper of the Young Guard there. This is not the one we're going to be making, or you can make out of this kit. Anyway, beautiful little illustration on card. What have we got here? Foot Grenadiers of the Guard. Famous grumblers. It says infantrymen who are a model for the entire Grand Army. The last reserve, only rarely figure in actual combat. But what qualities of courage and bearing were required for admission to the Grenadiers of the Guard? Okay, totally destroyed by the Allied forces at Waterloo, as was nearly all of Napoleon's army. And Napoleon, who had come back from exile after being defeated previously. So a serial loser, I suppose. Okay, anyway, these are the instructions, so So that's for the soldier. You can see there. This is for the officer. Okay. And this, I think that's something I printed off. It's not part of the kit. This was the bag of the officer in it. It's been mostly assembled, so disregard that. So no officer. We've got here in this bag. It says under there, soldier, soldat. This is just pieces though. He's obviously been assembled as well. And this is just the leftovers. So there might be some useful bits in there for some other figure. One of these, underlying principles of this Historex series is that you can switch between various figures and add parts from this one, put them on that one, etc. That was meant to be the idea. Now here's the, let's take him out. Here's the Sapper. Okay. Now obviously, he's a little bit of assembly work done. It doesn't look great. There's glue everywhere. It's yellowed. You might have to cut some of that off. But again, a lot of it will be covered up by, for example, this apron, heavy duty apron. So perhaps not so much to do on that. Okay, that's those two parts. Here's his coattails. You see they've got the nice fine decoration on those, but they go further because you get things like this. Let's see. Right, make sure that we're zoomed in a bit. You can see here there's a couple of belt buckles. I'm not sure what those are. Maybe they look familiar. I think maybe they go on some of the pouches. Then you've got some little grenades. And these are for the cuffs of the collar, of the jacket, I think. Again, more little decorations. And there's these little pioneer badges. You can see that. Let's see if we can get even closer in. Okay. Try and make sure it's focused on those. Okay, so you can see these Historex kits are superbly detailed. And they're very old. These are from at least, I think, the 1970s. But they were very well done. There's a little Imperial Eagle there. Okay, so as well detailed as these coattails are, you might be adding the little symbols to the ends of the coattails, etc., to make them even more detailed. Okay, here's his arms and hands. The hands, let's get that into, let's zoom back out again because I won't be able to see too much otherwise. Hands look a bit rudimentary. There's a bit of flesh there as well, which isn't really anything, but okay, something to think about there. Now some other bits. Here we've got some cord that's possibly for his either jacket or helmet, plume for his helmet, peak for his helmet, not helmet, it's a bear skin. I think that goes on the very, that circular part goes on the very top of the bear skin. And you've got other bits and pieces there. Those are the, for example, those are the cords that hang down. Okay, that's that. What's this? Looks like a tassel. I'll zoom you in again. See that, it's got a number on it. Is that 305? The light's not quite catching it. Okay, that's that. And here are his, I believe, his cuffs. Let's go on the end of his jacket and on the end of his arms. Okay, there we go. Over there. Be a little careful. Don't want to break them. They might have gone brittle over the years anyway. And that's where they're going to be going. Bearskin covered in glue that's gone yellow. So we can fix all that. Easy enough. Rifle. Now you see modern injection molded plastic kits. And people rave about the details on them, but this is not bad. This is from the 1970s. I mean, look at the details on this. You can see, let's do another zoom in. If I press, did I get it? Not sure, let's do that again. Okay, you can see the trigger guard and the trigger separate and the musket mechanism. Okay, this is a muzzle-loaded musket. Okay, and then a couple of little straps. I think those are for the belt of the musket. I don't know if the musket actually goes on the figure. All right, here's this pack. Let's get that into focus. I zoom back out a little bit. You can see that. Nicely detailed. Bit of flash. Needs cleaning up. Nothing too serious. As short sword bayonet. Well, if we use this rifle, he'll already have a bayonet. So we have to cut that one off. But again, some fine details on there. His axe. He is a sapper pioneer after all. So he's going to need this for taking down a few trees. I've ordered up some resin trees from a Reality and Scale. And I can put a couple of those on the base maybe. When it comes time to do that. Anyway, here's his shoulder epaulettes. Very nice. There's no decals for these. These are going to have to be painted by hand. It shouldn't be too difficult. It's just a spare piece of plastic. And what is that? Looks like a spare axe head. I'm not entirely sure. Let's do our zoom in thing again. And then click on that. Is it coming out? Do it again. There we go. Turn it over. Okay, I'll find out what that is exactly. I mean, it does look like a spare axe head when I'm putting them together. So that's that. Zoom back out again a bit. This is the bit that hangs off. I'm not sure what it's called. Is this sabretache or something? You can always refer back to the instructions. Now here we get to some of the important parts. And so it's time to zoom in again. And because he's very white, I don't know if it'll come out exactly clearly. But a nice fine head, I would say. That's a reasonable rival for a resin head. Not quite so much detail on the back, but he's going to be wearing a bearskin. It looks like, if I was really trimmed, and somebody's really trimmed it. I don't know if it was me or somebody else years and years ago. It's going to look a bit like that. Oops. Sorry, I went off camera. Let's put it back into focus again. There we go. Okay. So it needs a bit of work, but yeah. So let's zoom back out again. Yeah, this is little head. Okay, and Sapper, that's a little label for him, so we know what we're doing. And this is a sort of a material. I don't know what this is, cotton or something. I don't know what this is, but this is for making the straps with. As you'll see, like, he doesn't have that's the actual little body of the kit. And then if we go back to the box, you'll see, or he has straps here. Those are some of the small decorations I was talking about. Now he is carrying a rifle there, no bayonet fix because he's got it slung. There's his axe there. That possibly is either the cartridge pouch. Well, that, no, that's the spare axe head, isn't it? That looks like the spare axe head, because this is the back of the pioneer engineer Sapper here. And there's his sword and bayonet. You see his apron there with his bearded face. And there's some more of the decorations, plume. These are the cords that hang down. Those are his epaulettes, belt buckle, cuffs, you can see there. Yeah, this looks like it's going to be an interesting little job. And with that, I think I'll leave it there. Yeah. Okay, see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.